Now in this video, we discuss about the problem, define the perfect fluid and obtain the expression for energy moment and tensor for the perfect fluid. Proof of this is based on the theory of general relativity. A perfect fluid is a mechanical medium which is incapable of supporting any shearing stress and in which normal states are isotropic. By isotropic we mean that the point in which all the spatial directions are equivalent. To obtain formula for energy momentum tensor for perfect fluid, since for perfect fluid normal stresses are isotropic, thus for local observer the normal stresses are hydrostatic pressure P on the body, so T0 IJB energy stress or energy momentum tensor for perfect fluid in proper coordinate system. Then T0 IJ is equal to P into delta IJ where IJ is equal to 1, 2, 3 and etc. And T044 is equal to rho 0 since in proper coordinate the Galilean matrix hold good which we have that ds square is equal to minus dx square minus dy square minus dz square plus c square dt square. This is our equation number 3. So g011 is equal to minus 1, g022 is equal to minus 1, g033 is equal to minus 1 and g044 is equal to 1 upon c square. If g mu v and t mu v be the metric tensor, energy stress tensor for arbitrary coordinate system, then we have t mu v is equal to T0 ij delta x mu upon delta x 0 I into delta x nu upon delta x 0 j by the tensor law of transformation. Now then T mu v is equal to P into summation I and j is equal to 1 to 3 delta x mu upon delta x 0 I into delta x nu upon delta x 0 j plus rho 0 delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 into delta x nu upon delta x 4. This is our equation number 4 from equation 1 and 2. Also we get the value of g mu v is equal to g0 into ij delta x mu upon delta x 0 I into delta x nu upon delta x 0 j is equal to minus summation I and j is equal to 1 to 3 delta x mu upon delta x 0 I into delta x v upon delta x 0 j plus 1 upon c square delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 into delta x nu upon delta x 0 4. And then we get value of this is equal to minus into g ki power mu v minus 1 upon c square delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 into delta x nu upon delta x 0 4. This is our equation number 4. So using the equation 5 in 4, then we get T mu v, then we get the value, then T mu v is equal to minus P into g ki power mu v minus 1 by c square delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 into delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 plus rho 0 delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 into delta x mu upon delta x 0 4. This is equal to rho 0 plus P upon c square delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 into delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 minus P into g into mu minus mu. This is our equation number 6. Since the fluid is at rest in proper coordinate system, then delta x 0 upon ds is equal to 0 and delta dx 0 2 upon ds, dx 0 3 upon ds and dx 4 upon ds is equal to 1 by c. Now dx mu upon ds is equal to delta x mu upon delta x 0 v into delta x 0 v upon ds is equal to 1 upon c into delta x mu upon delta x 0 4. Similarly we get delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 is equal to c into dx mu upon ds and delta x mu upon delta x 0 4 is equal to c into dx mu upon ds. So t using these equation 7 and 8 in equation number 6, then we get t mu v is equal to rho 0 c square plus p upon c square into c square dx mu upon ds into dx nu upon ds minus p into g ki power mu into nu v. Now this is equal to P0 into C ki power P0 into C square plus P into Tx mu upon Ds into Dx mu pi Ds minus Dx mu upon Ds. So Tij is equal to P0 plus P into Vi into Vj minus Pgij where Vi is equal to Dx by Ds. This is the velocity component. If the C is taking in gravitational unit is 1, this result in a perfect energy momentum tensor for the fluid.